Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to introduce a website for you. In this website, you can download almost more than 1,000 free manga character in 3D. So first, we need to copy this link. This link I already put in the video description below. So you just need to click. So now I copy and paste here. So in this website, I can download a lot here. See, for example, I click here. Of course, I don't understand the Japanese, but all these are 3Ds that can download. But we need to filter it for the commercial purpose. We click it. So filter by condition of use, third party use, must tick yes. Can you download it? Yes. Avatar use? Yes, you can use the avatar. And the commercial use by individual for profit, and attribution you take unnecessary. By clicking and ticking all this, you will make sure that it will only filter those characters that can be used for commercial purpose and no need any attribution. Now I click OK. So all of these manga characters I can download. As demo, I download this. Right click, open in a new tab. After a few seconds, a 3D preview will appear here. So this is the 3D preview. If I feel satisfied, I can download. Condition of use, we can use for commercial. So for sure, we can use in our 3D animation or any of the YouTube video, our own project, our movie. Just to click use this model, agree to the condition of use. For all this attribution unnecessary, commercial use, yes, download. It will download as a VRM file. Click and show in folder. So this is the file that I just downloaded, this 2976 2976. As demo, I cut and paste on my desktop. This is the VRM file. So the next we are going to import into Blender. First, you just need to download the Blender. Download the latest version of Blender here. Download and install in your computer. And the next, you need another plugin to import the VRM file. So all this link I already put on the video description below. Just need to click. Okay, sorry. The next, you need this. This is the plugin, just to click here and download. After download, it is a zip file. I already successfully download on my desktop. I just need to right click, extract all, and click OK. So now, after extract, it will have the same location. It's on my desktop. I just need to search Blender. Here, right click the Blender, open file location, this shortcut will pop out. Next, you need to right click and properties. Again, find file location. Now you double click 2.83, open the script folder and open the add-on folder. So at here, just now, after you unzip it, you open the folder. Just now that one. So this one, and back. I need to copy this, copy, and paste in the add-on folder. Paste. Paste everything here. So to make sure that you already install the plugin, you just need to start Blender, go to the edit, preferences. Here you search GLTF, and make sure this one you must tick it. After you tick this, close it and file, import. So here you have a new plugin, the Kaysen GLTF 2.0. So use this one to import your VRM file. Now I can close the unnecessary windows. How can I import the VRM file? First, I need to rename this. Right click, rename. Remove the VRM and rename it, become GLB. Change the extension, select yes. Now it is a GLB file. If you are unable to see the GLB extension, then you need to go to the Explorer. Click view. Click the icon of option. Click view. Make sure you untick this. By default, it is ticked, so you cannot see the file extension. So you need to untick it, apply, so that you can see the file extension. To make sure that you can see, so that you can differentiate which one is OBJ file, which one is FBX file, and which one is GLB file. So now you already make sure this is GLB file. Close everything. I delete these three objects. And file, import, GLB, the final one, Kaysen GLTF 2.0. Click. This file is on my desktop. Just need to click desktop. Double click. So now this manga character already successfully import into Blender. Where is it? Okay, it's here. We click here to check. So now everything is quite okay. It is fully rigged and also the facial expression already in morph. So in this website, you can download everything here. It is over 1,000. I estimate it is over 1,000. Really a lot. And all are allowed for commercial use. And actually, how they create all this? They created all this manga character by using Vroid. You also can download the Vroid. So I also give you the URL to download the Vroid. This one. So just to download here, the Vroid Studio, you also can create your own manga character. After download, it is a zip file and I already unzip it. So I can just do a very simple demo, the Vroid Studio. These are the templates that you can continue to edit. If you want to create a really new character, you can just need to click plus. Say I want female, I just need to click. Now I can start design the manga character, how I operate. Right click can rotate, and middle click you can move the camera. First one is the face editor, you can edit the eyes. All the morph are here. All the morph. You can adjust everything, even eyebrow. Eyebrow, yeah. The nose, the mouth, really a lot. You can adjust it. And the ear, even the face line position, all you can adjust. After you feel satisfied, you can click the hair editor. To start brushing the hair, you can brush it here. Now you see all these nets, all these grids, all the boxes. Every time you brush, it automatically follow the grid. You also can adjust the shape. Just need to click here. Then you can just click on the dots and you can adjust the shape. And also the maximum length. Now the maximum length is until here. If I want to adjust the maximum length, I can just to pull. Then I can brush the maximum length to the bottom. And here also allow to undo. Just need to undo. Undo is Ctrl G. I can use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl G to reverse back. Undo everything. Now here you can design the hair. It's totally freestyle for you. And design whatever you want. The hair variables here, let's say I want to have a very small wave, it will become a just very small mesh. I make it big, then I can brush a very big mesh. So, and if something that I want to delete, I can just to click here. And I select the mesh that I want to delete. Just need to right click, delete. So now as demo, I just brush it as fast as possible. And make sure there's no space between the hair. This one you can adjust the size, the width. Of course, you can design it better than me. As demo, I just simply create the hair. So now, after I feel satisfied, I can create the body editor. Here, I can edit the body, the shoulder, everything, all about the body shape, you can adjust here. The legs length, everything you can adjust. The head size, even the burst, the brace volume, you can make it bigger. Okay, it's not that big. Okay, and the next is the clothing editor. You can choose that from here, the base model without clothes, the uniform, one piece. Accessory. You want a ribbon or don't want all this. Once you feel satisfied, you can just ignore the general editor and export. Go to export. Exporter. Now you see you want to export, you just to click here export. And now I click export. This one, you can ignore and just to click OK. On the desktop, as demo, I just to export here. Okay, girl02 demo. When I save it, it is a VRM file. Same as just now, you download all the free resources. These are VRM file. Save. After a while, it will appear the VRM file. It's here. So if you want to import into your Blender, just need to click File, New, General. Now I start a new project. I delete all this. I want to import the VRM file. I need to rename it from VRM to GLB. Enter. Change the file extension. Then you can export. You can import. File, Import, KSON. Choose Desktop. Double click the GLB. and also view the texture. All the morphs are complete. Girl 02 demo should be this. So again, this is a wrong model. File, import GLB should be on the desktop. The Girl 02 demo. Okay, this one is the correct one. Click to view the texture. Yes, this is successful import successfully. And let us check. All the rigs are complete. Facial morph, facial expression all complete in the morph. However, the files that you already exported out as BRM file, you already cannot edit it. But you can edit here. This one you can save the project, save as. This is girl02. I save it. So that when next time you open the Vroid, you still can re-edit it. Just need to demo. Now I close it. And I open. This is girl02 demo. I still can continue here. Because you already saved. And actually, where is the save file? The save file is inside your document. It's here. Document, Vroid, avatar, and the girl02 is here. So this is your save file location. And this is not the save file. This is already finalized and exported. Exported out, you cannot edit this. But of course, you can edit in Blender. You can sculpt it by using your sculpting tool, all this modeling. Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. If you love my video, if you love my tutorial, you can go to the bottom and click subscribe and turn on the mini bell so that when next time I publish a new tutorial, you receive the notification immediately. See you in my next video. Go to the bottom of the video and click subscribe. Click the bell to receive all the notifications for every time I publish a new video and tutorial if you love it. If you find it helpful, I will keep on post more and more tutorial for you.